What's up, guys? Mark Smith with JBS Training Group. This video is going to be on rifle bags, stability bags, support bags, rear bags, all that kind of stuff, and how you know which one you should get, why you care, all that kind of stuff. I rode the struggle bus for a long time, man, before I realized how useful a good bag could be. So we're just going to kind of dive into that, talk about all these different ones. As you can see, I got a plethora of good bags behind me. We'll go through some of the ones that I picked and why I figured out I didn't like them, and then some of the ones that I really, really like, and hopefully it'll give you guys some ideas on what you need to be shopping for when you're looking for rifle support bags. All right, so the first thing to answer is why, right? Why do I need a rear bag? Why do I need a support bag at all? And the short, sweet answer is there's really two principles of stability when you're shooting for precision, right? That is support the gun, and then support the body in that order, right? I wanna try to support the gun first. When I take a hard surface and I set it up against another hard surface, it creates fulcrum points and unstable, inconsistent positions, right? Guns can move, guns can pivot, all that kind of stuff. It's really hard for me to really stabilize the gun like I would want to. But if I can take this amount of surface area and increase it to that amount of surface area, I'm already gaining ground, right? So now I've got more surface area contacting the gun, right? I've also got a bag that's soft enough that can encompass a little bit of that rail and not just one part of it on the bottom. So I'm already significantly more stable than I would be just straight off of a standard hard surface. So that's rule number one, right? Support the gun, and these just help you to do that a lot better. So another super common thing that gets brought up is, well, hey Mark, how come not a bipod? Or hey Mark, how come I just wouldn't go prone, set the gun on the ground? Two different things. Let's talk about both of them real quick. So number one, the reason I don't prefer a bipod is that typically with most bipod feet, we're talking about getting rid of hard surfaces against hard surfaces, and most of the time bipod feet are somewhat, you know, more solid, more harder material than something like a bag. So we got a hard surface against hard surface, not going to be as stable. Another thing is that environments change, right? And consistency being the key to accuracy, I can't consistently get the same environment every time. So bipods in gravel are different than bipods in sand, bipods in dirt, bipods on hard man-made surfaces, things like that. It's a little bit different kind of thing going on. So that's typically why you won't see me using a bipod for much of anything. The other thing is, why not prone? Well, prone's great if you can get it, but it's not a very practical position, because most of the time in practical shooting, where you're actually, you know, in the field, in the woods, doing your thing, whatever, you go prone, you've immediately eliminated about 90% of your world, right? You're behind a bunch of brush, you're behind a bunch of sticks, you're behind a bunch of crap that you just can't see through. So prone is typically a great position if you can get it, but the problem is Murphy's Law being what it is, most of the time you can't get it. So that's why we use bags and use them to enhance our elevated positions. So we'll get into that now. All right, so right here behind me, we've got a whole mess of different bags, rear bags, support bags, what's the difference, all that kind of stuff. So let's dive into them. I'm gonna work through each one of them, talk about what each one of them gives that the other one doesn't, that kind of thing. Hopefully it'll help you guys make your mind up on which one works for you. All right, so first up is gonna be the Armageddon Gear Mini Game Changer. This is the wax-coated fabric, the super heavy one. You'll have a couple of different options when you pick bags. You can get the extra lightweight ones, the medium weight ones, and then these that are basically feel like they're filled with sand. Anything that's shaped kind of like that is gonna be what we refer to as a game changer. So why do I want a heavy one instead of a lighter one? So the deal with the heavy ones is, I typically find using the heavy ones, the bag itself is more stable, right? There's no real movement I can apply to the bag that causes it to kind of change shape. They also work really well for unorthodox angles, such as right angles and things like that, where they'll kind of go down, get set, and they're not going to really move around a lot. As with some of the lighter weight ones, you might have those bags trying to tilt forward out on you and stuff like that. So for really strange angles, you know, think of the grooves in tank traps, think of Ys in trees, stuff like that. The really heavy bags I typically prefer, but that's just one of all of them, right? And we'll just keep moving right on through that. All right, so next up, we've got the game changer that's got the straps on it, and this is the extra lightweight one. really conforms really well to a lot of stuff because there's not a ton of material in it. That's another thing when looking for a good bag. You don't want it too full. You want it to be able to conform. Another really neat thing about this one is the fact that because it has these straps, you think about, you know, gamers and stuff like that, you can open these straps up like so, set your rifle on the bag, and now I can strap the bag to my rifle, even over the top of my scope, so that I can be staged and ready to go on the beep, you know, whatever, drop it down, rock and roll. It stays with me through positions and that sort of thing. So, you know, a necessity, not really, but definitely nice to have in certain situations. And I have on one occasion taken these straps, wrapped them around a tree limb and ran the gun through there and created like a suspension stability platform there. So the lightweight ones, like I say, man, really easy and convenient to throw in a bag. It's not a lot of weight. And the bigger ones will absolutely conform to things a little bit better, give you a little bit better stability. So that's the strap light full size bag. All right, so next up we've got the full size sticky game changer. What's that mean, Mark? Well, so you notice that the fabric's different. So this is the standard, you know, regular fabric, and then this is some kind of weird wizardry that they've created that is like crazy sticky and will dang near like hold itself on anything. If you notice, I'm holding that with a finger, well, fell off, but you get the idea. This kind of sucks in and doesn't move a whole lot as far as the bag itself shifting on the barricade. It'll absolutely tilt a little bit here and there, but as far as moving on the barricade, really isn't gonna move a whole lot. Another neat thing about it is when you're actually using it, the gun in recoil is not gonna move as much because the sticky fabric, whatever that is, has hold of the gun. It's not gonna shift around as much on you. So that's a really cool one as well. Here in a second, I'll show you some other unorthodox kind of positions that you can utilize a sticky game changer in, and help you understand why that might work out for you. All right, and last but not least, as far as general support bags, is the mini sticky game changer. So far more convenient to carry something like this around just due to its size than it is something as big as the full size ones. This may be my favorite support bag, just because it's so practical for so many different things. Same as the other sticky one, it's gonna hold on, it's not gonna shift around, and the rifle's gonna hold on as well. And we can use it in some really weird, unorthodox positions, which I'll show you now. All right, so sometimes in life, the world doesn't give you perfect barricades to use perfect bag placement on, right? Insert sticky game changer. If I've got angled surfaces in my environment, I can take that, stick it right there to it. She's not gonna go anywhere. I can now set this rifle up on a supported position. I can utilize the back of this car jam or a door jam to support my body. I can use this bag to support the gun, and we can shoot from here, and the bag's not gonna go anywhere because it's a sticky game changer, and they're awesome, right? So what's another one? So I typically like, anytime I've got anything that is a slippery surface, such as car windshield, use the sticky game changer. If I've got the edge of a car door, I can use that to hang on to one part of an object and be able to utilize just something that sticks out just a little bit. Because if you take a typical normal fabric game changer or something similar and you set it on the edge of something, it's not gonna hang on like a sticky will. And when you go to load it, it's just gonna fall right off of there. But as you can see with the sticky one, you can just finger hold this thing, and she's not gonna go anywhere. It's really an awesome little bag. So yeah, any kind of weird angles, man, you can flip those things around and you can utilize them to stabilize the gun on that. Any sort of pressure you apply to it makes it just grab on even harder. So really like the sticky ones. All right, so talked about support bags in general. Now let's get into rear bags real quick. Why do I care? So rear bags provide me a secondary point of contact. If I've got a support bag and a rear bag, holy smokes, right? Now we're cooking with gas. So probably my favorite one, and I forget what it's called. It's a little flexible fabric bead filled bag by Armageddon Gear. If you don't notice a trend here, I'm a pretty big Armageddon Gear fan. It's kind of my one-stop shop for all my bag needs. But I can utilize this in a number of different ways. So number one, I can put it under my stock and I can use my hand pressure to raise and lower the gun. I use the rear bag to aim with, right? Raise and lower the gun, I can shift it left and right, trying to find that natural point of aim. If I've got weird, unorthodox positions, right? So normal size game changer here, I can take my my rear bag, and I can now turn it into a grip bag, right? I can rest the grip and my hand on that rear bag, controlling the aiming by squeezing the bag and moving the reticle around, right? And now, ooh-wee, super stable, right? Super stable. So I really like the flexible ones that are not filled to the gills with beads and filling, because they're so versatile, right? So versatile. Neat little thing to note, if you're just gonna have one, this ain't a bad one to have, right? I can utilize this as a support bag, right? I can utilize this to encompass the gun, because remember, that's my goal, is to encompass the gun, touch it everywhere I can, and create an environment that it has minimal fulcrum points in, right? I can totally use this from, you know, any sort of position that you would use a game changer for. Not saying it's better than a game changer, just saying it's a little more versatile sometimes than just a game changer. So something to think about with that rear bag. All right, so here's another neat one from, you guessed it, Armageddon Gear. This is the X bag. Neat thing about the X bag is just the way that you grab it and you can control it, right? So I can take this and I can stick it under my stock, just like I did with the Flex bag. And I can now utilize my hand to squeeze the gun and aim the gun up and down, slide the bag left and right, and get a good solid aiming point. This one is gonna be perhaps a little more stable than something like the Flex bag, but the Flex bag is gonna be able to be utilized in more positions, more barricades, just due to the fact that it'll conform to them easier. Neat thing about this X bag, it's got a QD swivel attachment point on the back, so I can just hang it off the back of the gun if I'm running around doing something in a stage or whatever. I know I'm going to use this at some point. I can just have it stuck on the gun. Running, you know, truck guns, man, you can have it stuck on the truck gun. And once again, if I need to, I can absolutely take this off and I can utilize this. This is absolutely going to be a better answer than just that, right? So. Neat little rear bag. Now I want to show you one that I don't like, just so that you understand what wrong looks like, because when you know what wrong looks like and you know what right looks like, makes this stuff kind of easier. So we'll get into that now. All right, so now let's talk about what is a bad bag. I keep this thing around just because I bought it and there's no sense in chunking it, but this is a very it's a very hard to use bag in multiple situations. Really, the only time you're ever gonna be able to use something like that is just sitting flat on a flat surface and resting the gun on it like that. That's about the extent of its use. Well, why is that, Mark? Well, because number one, it's a little bit too big and it's too full. So too full means I can't really get my hand on it to grab it and use it as a rear support, just because it's too much, man. And also because it's so full, it won't conform to surfaces very well. It'll just kind of fall off of there. You can't get it to stick. So it's kind of a one use sort of thing. Now I can absolutely use it to help support me, the shooter. So I can, you know, utilize it to kind of lean in on and support myself. But man, I don't want to carry around like 19 bags. You know what I mean? So good for some things, but not all things. Nowhere near all things. And just wanted to show you kind of what not a good bag is. I do not find this bag to be very versatile at all. However, it does have a really cool Kryptek camo pattern, which amounts to something for sure. All right, dude, so that's what I got on bags. Hopefully that all makes sense to you and gives you a little bit of a starting point to go forward with searching out for your own bag. Remember, bagging a gun isn't just for the 600-yard stuff and the precision shooters. Bagging a gun is for the 60-yard shot sometimes that you can't miss, right? The no-fail stuff. If you're riding around with truck guns and things like that, you may very well run into a situation one day where you can't miss, or it's going to be a bad day. So I definitely want to be cheating where I can, right? So I'm going to carry around a bag with me, be able to utilize it, understand what I can do with it, what I can't do with it, and you know, use it well. So hopefully that makes sense. And if you got any questions, drop them in the comments. I'll do my best to answer them. Otherwise, you can check out the upcoming Performance Out Yonder course coming up in Port Angeles, Washington. That's gonna be fantastic. It's LPVO centric course, man. What does it look like to take a rifle and do rifle stuff with it? I'm real big on capable riflemen, man. Let's use these things the way they were designed. Contrary to popular belief, this will absolutely shoot further than 25 to 50 yards. So let's see what that looks like, right? other than that, man, if you want to host a course, hit me up, jbstraininggroup@gmail.com. Check out the website, jbstraininggroup.com. All the course descriptions, register, see where I'm coming, your town, all that kind of stuff. Appreciate the heck out of you guys, man. Have a good day.